"What's the matter with your King?" asked Trot curiously. But the woman seemed frightened to have said so much. She retreated to her porch, merely saying, "The King punishes severely any treason on the part of his subjects."
"What's treason?" asked Button Bright.
"In this case," replied Cap'n Bill, "treason seems to consist of knocking the King, but I guess we know his disposition now as well as if the lady had said more."
"I wonder," said Trot, going up to the woman, "if you could spare us something to eat? We haven't had anything but popcorn and lemonade for a long time."
"Bless your heart! Of course I can spare you some food," the woman answered,
and entering her cottage, she soon returned with a tray loaded with sandwiches, cakes, and cheese. One of the children drew a bucket of clear cold water from a spring, and the three wanderers ate heartily and enjoyed the good things immensely. When Button Bright could eat no more, he filled the pockets of his jacket with cakes and cheese, and not even the children objected to this. Indeed, they all seemed pleased to see the strangers eat, so Cap'n Bill decided that no matter what the King of Jinxland was like, the people would prove friendly and hospitable.
"Whose castle is that yonder, ma'am?"
he asked, waving his hand toward the towers that rose above the trees.
"It belongs to His Majesty, King Krewl," she said.
"Oh, indeed, and does he live there?"
"When he is not out hunting with his fierce courtiers and war captains," she replied.
"Is he hunting now?" Trot inquired.
"I do not know, my dear. The less we know about the King's actions, the safer we are."